చక్షురన్మితం యేన తస్మై శ్రీగురవే నమః. నమో ఓం ఇష్టపాదాయ కృష్ణ ప్రేష్టాయ భూతలే శ్రీమతే భక్తి వేదాంత స్వామినిది నామినే. నమస్తే సరస్వతీ దేవే గౌరవాణి ప్రచారిణి నిర్విశేష శూన్యవాది పాశ్చాత్య దేశతారిణి. జయ శ్రీకృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభు నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధార శ్రీవాసాది గౌర భక్త వృంద వాంఛా కల్పతరూపేశ కృపా సింధు హేవచ పతితానా పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమో నమః. హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే హరే, హరే రామ 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 హరే హరే. లెట్ మీ షేర్ మై స్క్రీన్. So we were reading the ninth chapter, the first canto. Bhishma Deva leaves his body. 1939. Vijayarata kutumba atartotre dhrutahaya rashminita priyekshanye bhagavati ratir astume mumur smushtur ట్రాన్స్లేషన్ పర్పట్ బై డివైన్ గ్రేస్ చేసి భక్తి వేదాంత శ్రీ ప్రభుపాదకి జై. హరే కృష్ణ స్వప్నమాత, హరే కృష్ణ స్వప్నమాతజీ, హరే కృష్ణ మెల్లమాతజీ, చెప్పండి. హరే కృష్ణ మెల్లమాతజీ, హరిదే.
హరే కృష్ణ, సారీ. ట్రాన్స్లేషన్: ఎట్ ద మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ డెత్ లెట్ మై అల్టిమేట్ అట్రాక్షన్ టు బి శ్రీకృష్ణ, ద పర్సనాలిటీ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ హెడ్. ఐ కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ మై మైండ్ అపాన్ ద చారియట్ డ్రైవర్ ఆఫ్ అర్జున, హూ స్టూడ్ విత్ అ విప్ ఇన్ హిస్ రైట్ హ్యాండ్ అండ్ అ బ్రిడిల్ రోప్ ఇన్ హిస్ లెఫ్ట్, హూ వాజ్ వెరీ కేర్ఫుల్ టు గివ్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ టు అర్జునస్ చారియట్ బై ఆల్ మీన్స్. Those who saw him on the battlefield of Kurukshetra attained their original forms after death. Purport: A pure devotee of the Lord constantly sees the presence of the Lord within himself because of being transcendentally related by loving service. Such a pure devotee cannot forget the Lord for a moment. This is called trance. The mystic yogi tries to concentrate upon the super soul by controlling the senses from all other engagements, and thus he ultimately attains samadhi. A devotee more easily attains samadhi or trance by constantly remembering the Lord's personal feature along with his holy name, fame, pastimes, etc. Therefore, the concentration of mystic yogi and that of a devotee are not on the same level. The concentration of a mystic is mechanical, whereas that of a pure devotee is natural and in pure love and spontaneous affection. Bhishma Deva was a pure devotee, and as a military marshal, he constantly remembered the battlefield feature of the Lord as Parthasarathi, the chariot driver of Arjuna. Therefore, the Lord's pastimes as Parthasarathi is also eternal. The pastimes of the Lord, beginning from his birth at the prison of house of Kamsa up to the Mausala Leela at the end, all move one after another in all the universes, just as the clock hand moves from one point to another. And in such pastimes, his associates like Pandavas and Bhishma are constant eternal companions. So Bhishma Deva never forgot the beautiful feature of the Lord as Parthasarathi, which even Arjuna could not see. Arjuna was behind the beautiful Parthasarathi, while Bhishma Deva was in front of the Lord. As far as the military feature of the Lord is concerned, Bhishma Deva observed this with more relish than Arjuna. Hare Krishna.
All the soldiers and persons on the battlefield of Kurukshetra attained their original spiritual form like the Lord after death, because by the causeless mercy of the Lord they were able to see him face to face on that occasion. The conditioned souls rotating in the evolutionary cycle from the aquatics up to the form of Brahma are all in the form of Maya, or the form obtained by one's own actions and awarded by material nature. The material forms of the conditioned souls are all foreign dresses. And when the conditioned soul becomes liberated from the clutches of material energy, he attains his original form. The impersonalist wants to attain the impersonal Brahman effulgence of the Lord, but that is not all congenial to the living sparks, parts and parcels of the Lord. Therefore, the impersonalists again fall down and get material forms, which are all false to the spirit soul. A spiritual form like the Lord's, either two-handed or four-handed, is attained by the devotees of the Lord either in the Vaikunthas or in the Goloka planet according to the original nature of the soul. This form, which is sent person spiritual, is the Swarupa of the living being, and all the living beings who participated on the battlefield of Kurukshetra on both sides attained their Swarupa as confirmed by Bhishma Deva. So Lord Sri Krishna was not merciful only to the Pandavas, he was also merciful to the other parties because all of them attained the same result. Bhishma Deva wanted the same facility also, and that was his prayer to the Lord. Although his position as associate of the Lord is assured in all circumstances. The conclusion is that whoever dies looking on the personality of Godhead within or without attains his Swarupa, which is the highest perfection of life. Hare Krishna.
40. Dalita gati vilasa valguhasa pranaya nirikshana kalpitor munaha kritam anukrutvatya unmadhananda prakrutim agan kila yasya gopa vadvaha. Translation purport by Divine Deity Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna, Abhishek Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, translation. Let my mind be fixed upon Lord Sri Krishna, whose motions and smiles of love attracted the damsels of Vrajadhama, the gopis. The damsels imitated the characteristic movements of Lord after his disappearance from the rasa dance. Purport. By intense ecstasy in loving service, the damsels of Rajabhumi attained qualitative oneness with the Lord by dancing with him on an equal level, embracing him in nuptial love, smiling at him in joke, and looking at him with a loving attitude. The relation of the Lord with Arjuna is undoubtedly praiseworthy for devotees like Bhishma Deva, but the relation of the gopis with the Lord is still more praiseworthy because of their still more purified loving service. By the grace of the Lord, Arjuna was fortunate enough to have the fraternal service of the Lord as a chariot driver, but the Lord did not award Arjuna with equal strength. The gopis, however, practically became one with the Lord by the attainment of equal footing with the Lord. Bhishma's aspiration to remember the gopis is a prayer to have their mercy also at the last stage of his life. The Lord is satisfied more when his pure devotees are glorified, and therefore Bhishma Deva has not only glorified the acts of Arjuna, his immediate object of attraction, but also remembered the gopis who were endowed with unrivaled opportunities for rendering loving service to the Lord. The gopis' equality with the Lord should never be misunderstood to be like the Sayujya liberation of the impersonalist. The equality is one of perfect ecstasy where the differential conception is completely eradicated, for the interests of the lover and beloved become identical.
41. Munigana rupa varya sankule nantaha sadasi yudhisthira rajasuya esham arhanam upaveda ikshaniyo mama drushi gochar esha avir atmaha. Translation performed by Divine Deity Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna Nityananda.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Translation. At the Rajasuya Yagna sacrifice performed by Maharaja Yudhishthira, there was the greatest assembly of all the elite men of the world, the royal and learned orders, and in that great assembly, Lord Sri Krishna was worshipped by one and all as the most exalted personality of Godhead. This happened during my presence, and I remember the incident in order to keep my mind upon the Lord. Purport. After gaining victory in the battle of Kurukshetra, Maharaja Yudhishthira, the emperor of the world, performed the Rajasuya sacrificial ceremony. The emperor in those days, upon his ascendance to the throne, would send a challenge horse all over the world to declare his supremacy. And any ruling prince or king was at liberty to accept the challenge and express his tacit willingness either to obey or to disobey the supremacy of the particular emperor.
One who accepted the challenge had to fight with the emperor and establish his own supremacy by victory. The defeated challenger would have to sacrifice his life, making a place for another king or ruler. So Maharaja Yudhishthira also dispatched such challenging horses all over the world, and every ruling prince and king all over the world accepted Maharaja Yudhishthira's leadership as the emperor of the world. After this, all rulers of the world under the regime of Maharaja Yudhishthira were invited to participate in the great sacrificial ceremony of Rajasuya. Such performance requires hundreds of millions of dollars, and it was not an easy job for a petty king. Such a sacrificial ceremony being too expensive and also difficult to perform under present circumstances is now impossible in this age of Kali. Nor can anyone secure the required expert priesthood to take charge of the ceremony. So after being invited, all the kings and great learned sages of the world assembled in the capital of Maharaja Yudhishthira. The learned society, including the great philosophers, religionists, physicians, scientists, and all great sages, was invited. That is to say, the Brahmanas and the Kshatriyas were the topmost leading men in society, and they were all invited to participate in the assembly. The Vaishyas and Sudras were unimportant elements in society, and they are not mentioned herein. Due to the change of social activities in the modern age, the importance of men has also changed in terms of occupational positions. So, in that great assembly, Lord Sri Krishna was the cynosure of neighboring eyes. Everyone wanted to see Lord Krishna, and everyone wanted to pay his humble respects to the Lord. Bhishma Deva remembered all this and was glad that his worshipful Lord, the personality of Godhead, was present before him in his actual formal presence. So, to meditate on the Supreme Lord is to meditate on the activities, form, pastimes, name and fame of the Lord. That is easier than what is imagined as meditation on the impersonal feature of the Supreme. In the Bhagavad Gita 12.5, it is clearly stated that to meditate upon the impersonal feature of the Supreme is very difficult. It is practically no meditation or simply a waste of time, because very seldom is the desired result obtained. The devotees, however, meditate upon the Lord's factual form and pastimes, and therefore the Lord is easily approachable by the devotees. This is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita 12.9. The Lord is non-different from his transcendental activities. It is indicated also in this shloka that Lord Sri Krishna, while actually present before human society, especially in connection with the battle of Kurukshetra, was accepted as the greatest personality of the time. Although he might not have been recognized as the supreme personality of Godhead. The propaganda that a very great man is worshipped as God after his death is misleading, because a man after his death cannot be made into God, nor can the personality of Godhead be a human being, even when he is personally present. Both ideas are misconceptions. The idea of anthropomorphism cannot be applicable in the case of Lord Krishna. Hare Krishna.
42. Tam imam aham ajam sarira bhajam. Hrudi hrudi tishtitam atmakalpitam pratidrisham iva naikadharakam ekam samadigato asmi vidutha bheda moha. Translation and purport by Divande A.C. Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Hare Krishna Swapna Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Translation. Now I can meditate with full concentration upon that one Lord, Sri Krishna, now present before me, because now I have transcended
the misconceptions of duality in regard to his presence in everyone's heart, even in the hearts of the mental speculators. He is in everyone's heart. The sun may be perceived differently, but the sun is one. Lord Sri Krishna is one absolute personality of Godhead, but he has expanded himself into his multiplanary portions by his inconceivable energy. The conception of duality is due to the ignorance of his inconceivable energy. In the Bhagavad Gita 9.11, the Lord says that only the foolish take him to be mere human being. Such foolish men are not aware of his inconceivable energies. By his inconceivable energy, he is present in everyone's heart. As the sun is present before everyone all over the world, the Paramatma feature of the Lord is an expansion of his plenary portions. He expands himself as Paramatma in everyone's heart by his inconceivable energy. And he also expands himself as the glowing effulgence of Brahma Jyoti by expansion of his personal glow. It is stated in the Brahma Samhita that the Brahma Jyoti is his personal glow. Therefore, there is no difference between him and his personal glow. Brahma Jyoti or his plenary portions as Paramatma. Less intelligent persons who are not aware of this fact consider Brahma Jyoti and Paramatma to be different from Sri Krishna. This misconception of duality is completely removed from the mind by Bhishma Deva, and he is now satisfied that it is the Lord Sri Krishna only who is in all in everything. This enlightenment is attained by the great Mahatmas or devotees. As it is stated in Bhagavad Gita 7.19 that Vasudeva is all in everything, and that there is no existence of anything without Vasudeva. Vasudeva or Lord Sri Krishna is the original Supreme Person. As now confirmed by a Mahajana, and therefore both the neophytes and the pure devotees must try to follow in his footsteps. This is the way of devotional life. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Sagar.
Hare Krishna, the worshipable object of Brahmadeva is Lord Sri Krishna as Parthasarathi, and that of the gopis is the same Krishna in Vrindavana as the most attractive Shyama Sundara. Sometimes less intelligent scholars make a mistake by and think that the Krishna and Vrindavana and that of the battle of Kurukshetra are different personalities. But for Bhishma Deva, this misconception is completely removed. Even the impersonalist object of destination is Krishna as the impersonal Jyoti. And the yogi's destination of Paramatma is also Krishna. Krishna is both Brahma Jyoti and the localized Paramatma. But in Brahma Jyoti or Paramatma, there is no Krishna or sweet relationship with Krishna. In his personal feature, Krishna is both Parthasarathi and Shyamasundara of Vrindavana. But in his impersonal feature, he is neither in the Brahma Jyoti nor in the Paramatma. Great Mahatmas like Vishnu realized all these different features of Lord Sri Krishna, and therefore they worship Lord Krishna, knowing him as the origin of all features. Hare Krishna.
ಸೂತವಾಚ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಏವಂ ಭಗವತಿ ಮನೋವಾಗ್ದೃಷ್ಟಿ ವೃತ್ತಿಃ ಆತ್ಮನಿ ಆತ್ಮನಂ ಅವೇಶ್ಯ ಸೋ ಅಂತಃಸ್ವಸ ಉಪಾರಮ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಷನ್ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ದಿವೈನ್ ಎಸಿ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವೇದನ್ ಶ್ರೀಪಾದಿಕಿ ಜೈ ಹರಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪುಷ್ಕಲ
ಸುತಗೋಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಸೇಟ್ ತಸ್ ಭೀಷ್ಮದೇವ ಮರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೂಪರ್ ಸೋಲ್ Lord Shri Krishna, the supreme personality of Godhead, with his mind, speech, sight, and actions, enters. He became silent and his breathing stopped. Purport: the stage attained by Bhishma Deva while quitting his material body is called Nirvikalpa Samadhi, because he merged himself into thinking of the Lord and his mind into remembering his different activities. He chanted the glories of the Lord, and by his sight he began to see the Lord personally present before him, and thus all his activities became concentrated upon the Lord without deviation. This is the highest stage of perfection, and it is possible for everyone to attain this stage by practice of devotional service. The devotional service of the Lord consists of 9 principles of service activities. They are hearing, chanting, remembering, serving the lotus feet, worshipping, praying, executing the orders, fraternizing, and fully surrendering. Any one of them or all of them are equally competent to award the desired result, but they require to be practiced persistently under the guidance of an expert devotee of the Lord. The first item, hearing, is most important item of all, and therefore hearing of the Bhagavad Gita and later on Srimad Bhagavatam is essential for the serious candidate who wants to attain the stage of Bhishma Deva at the end. The unique situation at Bhishma Deva's time of death can be attained even though Lord Krishna may not be personally present. His words of Bhagavad Gita or those of Srimad Bhagavatam are identical with the Lord. They are sound incarnations of the Lord, and one can fully utilize them to be entitled to attain the stage of Sri Bhishma Deva, who was one of the 8 Vasus. Every man or animal must die at a certain stage of life. But one who dies like Bhishma Deva attains perfection. One who dies forced by the laws of nature dies like an animal. That is difference between a man and an animal. The human form of life is especially meant for dying like Bhishma Deva. Hare Krishna.
44. Sampadhyamanam agnaya Bhishmam brahmani niskale सर्वे बभूवुस्ते तुष्णीम वयमशिव दिनत्यया पैसेज परफेक्ट बन दिवान के ऐसे भक्ति वेद सर प्रभुपाद की जय हरे कृष्ण मेल्ला माता जी हरे कृष्ण मेल्ला माता जी हरे कृष्ण सरसी जी माता जी
into the unlimited eternity of the Supreme Absolute, all present there became silent like birds at the end of the day. Purport, to enter into or to become merged into the unlimited eternity of the Supreme Absolute means to enter the original home of the living being. The living beings are all component parts and parcels of the Absolute Personality of Godhead, and therefore they are eternally related with Him as the servitor and the served. The Lord is served by all His parts and parcels as the complete machine is served by its parts and parcels. Any part of the machine removed from the whole is no longer important. Similarly, any part and parcel of the Absolute detached from the service of the Lord is useless. The living beings who are in the material world are all disintegrated parts and parcels of the Supreme Whole, and they are no longer as important as the original parts and parcels. There are, however, more integrated living beings who are eternally liberated. The material energy of the Lord called Durga Shakti, or the superintendent of the prison house, takes charge of the disintegrated parts and parcels, and thus they undergo a conditioned life under the laws of material nature. When the living being becomes conscious of this fact, he tries to go back home, back to Godhead, and thus the spiritual urge of the living beings begins. This spiritual urge is called Brahma Jignyasa, or inquiry about Brahman. Principally, this Brahma Jignyasa is successful by knowledge, renunciation, and devotional service to the Lord. Jnana, or knowledge, means knowledge of everything of Brahman, the Supreme. Renunciation means detachment of material affection, and devotional service is the revival by practice of the original position of the living being. The successful living beings who are eligible to enter into the realm of the Absolute are called the Jnanis, the Yogis, and the Bhaktas. The Jnanis and Yogis enter into the impersonal rays of the Supreme, but the Bhaktas enter into the spiritual planets known as the Vaikunthas. In these spiritual planets, the Supreme Lord as Narayana predominates, and the healthy, unconditioned living beings live there by rendering loving service to the Lord in the capacity of servant, friend, parents, and fiancé. there are the unconditioned living beings enjoy life in full freedom with the Lord, whereas the impersonalist jnanis and yogis enter into the impersonal glowing effulgence of the Vaikuntha planets. The Vaikuntha planets are all self-illuminating like the sun, and the rays of the Vaikuntha planets are called Brahma Jyoti. The Brahma Jyoti is spread unlimitedly, and the material world is but a covered portion of an insignificant part of the same Brahma Jyoti. This covering is temporary, and therefore it is a sort of illusion. Bhishma Deva, as a pure devotee of the Lord, entered the spiritual realm in one of the Vaikuntha planets, where the Lord in his eternal form of Parthasarathi predominates over the unconditioned living beings who are constantly engaged in the service of the Lord. The love and the affection which bind the Lord and devotee are exhibited in case of Bhishma Deva. Bhishma Deva never forgot the Lord in his transcendental feature as the Parthasarathi, and the Lord was present personally before Bhishma Deva while he was passing to the transcendental world. That is the highest perfection of life. Hare Krishna.
Tatra tunduva yonedu deva manava vadita sasamsu sadho ragna katapetu pushpa Pushpa Vatsaya, translated by Purport by Jivanti A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ki Jai. Hare Krishna Abhishek Prabhu.
Translation. Thereafter, both men and demigods sounded drums in honor, and the honest royal order commenced demonstrations of honor and respect, and from the sky fell showers of flowers. Purport. Bhishma Deva was respected both by the human beings and by the demigods. The human beings live on earth and similar other planets in the Bhur and Bhuvar group of planets. But the demigods live in the Swar or heavenly planets. And all of them knew Bhishma Deva as a great warrior and devotee of the Lord. As a Mahajana or authority, he was on the level of Brahma, Narada and Shiva, although he was a human being. Qualification on a par with the great demigods is possible only on attainment of spiritual perfection. Thus, Bhishma Deva was known all over the universes, and during his time, interplanetary travel was effected by finer methods than the futile endeavors of mechanical spacecraft. When the distant planets were informed of the passing of Bhishma Deva, all the inhabitants of the upper planets as well as of the earth dropped showers of flowers to show due respect to the departed great personality. This showering of flowers from heaven is a sign of recognition by great demigods. It should never be compared to the decoration of a dead body. The body of Bhishma Deva lost its material effects due to being surcharged with spiritual realization, and thus the body was spiritualized as when iron becomes red hot when in contact with fire. So the body of a fully self-realized soul is not therefore accepted as material. Special ceremonies are observed for such spiritual bodies. The respect and recognition of Bhishma Deva are never to be imitated by artificial means, as it has become a fashion to observe the so-called Jayanti ceremony for any and every common man. According to authorized sastras, such a Jayanti ceremony for an ordinary man, however exalted he may be materially, is an offense to the Lord, because Jayanti is reserved for the day when the Lord appears on the earth. Bhishma Deva was unique in his activities, and his passing away to the kingdom of God is also unique.
6. Tasya niraharanadini samparetasya bhargava yudhishthira karyatva muhurtam dukkito abhava. Translation purport by Jivanti A.C. Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Santamandi.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Translation. O descendant of Bhrigu, Saunaka, after performing funeral rituals for the dead body of Bhishma Deva, Maharaja Yudhishthira was momentarily overtaken with grief. Purport. Bhishma Deva was not only a great family head of Maharaja Yudhishthira, but also he was a great philosopher and friend to him, his brothers, and his mother. Since Maharaja Pandu, the father of the five brothers headed by Maharaja Yudhishthira, had died, Bhishma Deva was the most affectionate grandfather of the Pandavas and caretaker of the widow daughter-in-law Kunti Devi. Although Maharaja Dhritarashtra, the elder uncle of Maharaja Yudhishthira, was there to look after them, his affection was more on the side of his 100 sons, headed by Duryodhana. Ultimately, a colossal clique was fabricated to deprive the 5 fatherless brothers of the rightful claim of the kingdom of Hastinapura. There was a great intrigue common in imperial palaces, and the 5 brothers were exiled to the wilderness. But Bhishmadeva was always a sincerely sympathetic well-wisher, grandfather, friend, and philosopher to Maharaja Yudhishthira, even up to the last moment of his life. He died very happily by seeing Maharaja Yudhishthira to the throne. Otherwise, he would have long ago quitted his material body instead of suffering agony over the undue sufferings of the Pandavas. He was simply waiting for the opportune moment because he was sure and certain that the sons of Pandu would come out victorious in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, as his lordship Sri Krishna was their protector. As a devotee of the Lord, he knew that the Lord's devotee cannot be vanquished at any time. Maharaja Yudhishthira was quite aware of all these good wishes of Bhishma Deva, and therefore he must have been feeling the great separation. He was sorry for the separation of a great soul and not for the material body which Bhishma Deva relinquished. The funeral ceremony was a necessary duty, although Bhishma Deva was a liberated soul. Since Bhishma Deva was without issue, the eldest grandson, namely Maharaja Yudhishthira, was the rightful person to perform this ceremony. It was a great boon to Bhishma Deva that an equally great son of the family undertook the last rites of a great man. Hare Krishna.
47. Tushruvor munayo hrushta Krishnam tadguhya namavi tataste Krishna hrudaya swasraman prayayu punaha. Translation purport by Jivanandi S. Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna Swapna Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. All the translation, all the great sages then glorified Lord Sri Krishna, who was present there by confidential Vedic hymns. Then all of them returned to their respective hermitages, bearing always Lord Krishna within their hearts. Purport. The devotees of the Lord are always in the heart of the Lord, and the Lord is always in the hearts of devotees. That is the sweet relation between the Lord and his devotees. Due to the unalloyed love and devotion for the Lord, the devotees always see him within themselves. And the Lord also, although he has nothing to do and nothing to aspire to, is always busy in attending to the welfare of his devotees. For the ordinary living beings, the law of nature is there for all actions and reactions. But he is always anxious to put his devotees on the right path. The devotees, therefore, are under the direct care of the Lord, and the Lord also voluntarily puts himself under the care of his devotees only. So all the sages headed by Vyasadeva were devotees of the Lord, and therefore they chanted the Vedic hymns after the funeral ceremony, just to please the Lord, who was present there personally. All the Vedic hymns are chanted to please Lord Krishna. This is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 15.15. All the Vedas, Upanishads, Vedanta, etc. are seeking him only, and all hymns are for glorifying him only. The sages therefore perform the exact acts suitable for the purpose, and they happily departed for their respective hermitages. Hare Krishna.
48. Tato Yudhishthiro gatva saha Krishno gajahvyayam pitaram santavyam asa gandharim cha tapasvinayam. Translation and purport by Jivanandi S. Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Hare Krishna Jagannath Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Thereafter, Maharaja Yudhishthira at once went to the capital Hastinapura, accompanied by Lord Sri Krishna, and there are consolidated his uncle and aunt Gandhari, who was on the ascetic. Perfect. Dhritarashtra and Gandhari, the father and the mother, of Duryodhana and his brothers, was the elder uncle and aunt of Maharaja Yudhishthira. After the battle of Kurukshetra, the celebrated couple, having lost all their sons and grandsons, were under the case of Maharaja Yudhishthira. They were passing their days in great agony over such a heavy loss of life and were practically living the life of ascetics. The death news of Bhishma Deva, uncle of Dhritarashtra, was another great shock for the king and the queen. And therefore, they required solace from Maharaja Yudhishthira. Maharaja Yudhishthira was conscious of his duty, and he at once hurried to the spot with the Lord Krishna and satisfied the bewailed Dhritarashtra with the kind words from the both himself and the Lord also. Gandhari was the powerful ascetic, although she was living the life of a beautiful wife and a king mother. It is said that Gandhari also voluntarily closed her eyes because of the blindness of her husband. A wife's duty is to follow the husband's sent person. And Gandhari was so true to her husband that she followed him even in his perpetual blindness. Therefore, in the actions, she was a great ascetic. Besides that, the shock she suffered because of the wholesale killing of her 100 sons and her grandsons also was certainly too much for a woman. But she suffered all this just like an ascetic. Gandhari, although a woman, is no less than Bhishma Deva in character. They are both remarkable personalities in the Mahabharata. Hare Krishna.
49. Pitra Chanumato Raja Vasudeva Anumodita Chakara Rajyam Dharmena Pitra Paitamaham Vibhum. Translation of Purport by Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Srila Prabhupada ki hai. Hare Krishna Sagar Prabhu. First two paragraphs. Hare Krishna Pushkala, you can read.
After this, the great religious king Maharaja Yudhishthira executed the royal power in the kingdom strictly according to the codes of royal principles approved by his uncle and confirmed by Lord Shri Krishna. Purport: Maharaja Yudhishthira was not a mere tax collector. He was always conscious of his duty as a king, which is no less than that of a father or spiritual master. The king is to see to the welfare of the citizens from all angles of social, political, economic, and spiritual upliftment. The king must know that human life is meant for liberating the encased soul from the bondage of material conditions, and therefore his duty is to see that the citizens are properly looked after to attain this highest stage of perfection. Maharaja Yudhishthira followed this principle strictly, as will be seen from the next chapter. Not only did he follow the principles, but he also got approval from his old uncle, who was experienced in political affairs, and it was also confirmed by Lord Krishna, the speaker of philosophy of Bhagavad Gita. Maharaja Yudhishthira is the ideal monarch, and monarchy under a trained king like Maharaja Yudhishthira is by far the most superior form of government, superior to modern republics of governments of people, by the people. The mass of people, especially in this age of Kali, are all born Sudras, basically low-born, ill-trained, unfortunate, and badly associated. They themselves do not know the highest perpetual aim of life. Therefore, votes cast by them actually have no value, and thus persons elected by such irresponsible votes cannot be responsible representatives like Maharaja Yudhishthira. Thus, in the Bhakti Vedanta purpose of first canto, 9th chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled The Passing Away of Bhishma Deva in the Presence of Lord Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So we have completed 9 chapters. So next Tuesday, we'll start with the 10th chapter, which is nothing but the departure of Lord Krishna for the Dwaraka. We'll read it in next Tuesday at the same time, 7:30. Hare Krishna. Thank you all for joining today's session. वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यः कृपा सिन्धुभ्यः च पद्मानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो अनंतकोटि वैष्णववृन्दकी जय श्री प्रभुपाद की जय ग्रंथराशिं भागवतम की जय थैंक यू सपना माताजी धन्यवाद प्रणाम थैंक यू अनिता माताजी
कृष्ण प्रभु धन्यवाद प्रणाम
थैंक यू सरस्वती माताजी अभिषेक प्रभु एवरीवन थैंक यू सो मच